phenomenon now. Everybody's moving into cities and leaving this happening all over the world, massive urbanization. The Dajjal enters into cities, he'll enter into every city in 40 days. And they asked him, in Sahih, it's a Sahih Hadith, كيف سرعته يومئذ يا رسول الله? And he said, كريحن or كغيذن استدبرته السحاب, like a wind that leaves behind condensation. And that's, I guarantee you, it's an exact translation. Like a wind that leaves behind condensation or a cloud. And if you look at the modern, and then in another hadith, يَرَكَبُ حِمَارًا مَا بَيْنُ أُذْنَيْهِ أَرْبَعُونَ ذِرَاعًا. He rides a donkey that has 40 cubits between its ears. Right? And I had a list of wingspans and worked out that actually the Learjet is almost exactly 40 cubits. Right? So, and then the other thing, one of the Sahaba thought that he was coming, the Dajjal, and he came to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm so frightened. And he said, from what? And he said, the Dajjal. And he said, why? And he said, because I heard he has a mountain of grain, and I heard that he commands the sky and it rains. And the hadith says, Huwa ahwanu ala Allahi min dhalika. He's less significant for Allah than that. And the ulama interpret that to mean that it won't be like magic. He won't just point to the sky. There'll be asbab. But he'll have amazing asbab means to do that. But there'll be means that people can understand, like engineers and things like that. In the light of Pakistan developing nuclear weapons, what is the Islamic position considering euphoria amongst the Muslims and the backlash of the non-Muslims? I think it's sign of the times. It's unfortunate. India, according to in India, what they're trying to do, the Americans are actually part of their New World Order policy is to support India. And I really actually wanted to show it's very interesting. You can see here, this is from Huntington's thesis, and what he's saying basically is that, the next war is a civilizational war between civilizations, and what he's saying basically is that when we look at civilizations, the question is no longer which side are you on, but who are you, right? The question is no longer which side are you on, but who are you? Which is why in Oklahoma, when there was a bombing, some people tried to get, they saw some Muslim immigrant there, and they were going to tie him. He said, no, I'm not one of those kind of Muslims. Like, I drink and I, It doesn't make any difference. They don't care. Even if you're a bad Muslim, if you're a Muslim, they don't care, I guarantee you. They don't care if you're a secular Muslim. If you have a Muslim name, particularly if you're brown, right? Because he's very obsessed with brown people in the book, it's all. But anyway, you can see the West, right? These links here are less conflictual. So the broader the white is, the less conflictual it is with the West. And what he's saying is the West, right, this is the civilization that has to maintain its supremacy over the other civilizations. Now, if you look, Japan, who Hitler called them yellow Aryans, it's less conflictual. And even in South Africa, they were honorary whites. People forget that. So the Japanese are in the Trilateral Commission. They're part of the whole...